Good evening and a very warm welcome to the Insider Essay, your guide to living better. Join us today as we see how the industry opens up with creativity that's making for big business. SAMA-winning songwriter Shekhinah pens her personal journey into smash hits. Adéle, Grosse turns her underwater photography into the coolest decor brand. As the Living Soils Initiative proves, when a woman learns to farm, her whole community grows. By dressing furniture like a fashion designer, Lorna Bailey gets her fabrics on the gram. Courtesy of a new super app, the latest mall is opening on our devices. Designer James White begins to turn a profit from his graffiti-inspired rugs. Getting the best invite she ever saw, TikTok sensation Nangamso Puwani gets dressed for the virtual viewing party of the year. David Tlale's flair for design creates opportunities in his small hometown of Vosloorus. And spot the clues in the show and stand a chance of winning a smartphone worth 20,000 Rand by answering the weekly show-related question on our social media pages. Musician Shekhinah has earned 5-star timeout in this most French corner of our land. Back from a gig in Kenya, she's now able to start touring her second album.
What's up? My name is Shekhinah, and for those who don't know, I'm a singer-songwriter. I hail from Durban, but today we are in Franschhoek, so please join me as we explore this beautiful space. So I got into music, I think, when I was maybe in grade 9 or 10, theater. And in doing that, I realized that I just wanted to be me, no script, unfiltered. And that's when I decided to become a songwriter. I started writing music in 2012 in Matric, and it's my favorite thing in the world. I hope to be a songwriter my whole life. My biggest breakthrough into music was when I thought music was failing me. Went back to college. And moved to a big city, all of that kind of inspired me to go home. And then I wrote a beautiful song about going home and about the beach. And that ended up being a breakout song for me. And it will forever be a standout in my career. So the first song we released was Back to the Beach, and it changed my life. Siblings and family play a big role in where I am today. It was my sister and her boyfriend that convinced me to audition for a talent show when I was 16. If they didn't convince me to go, I wouldn't be here today.
How do you know who's telling the truth?
When opportunity knocked again to show she could grab and hold a movie audience, she took it.
So many different people.
We shot a short film last year for Fixate. I think it's one of the coolest things I've ever done. I got to collaborate with people that I actually grew up with, but also young, new, up-and-coming directors and writers. The Fixate short film really just focuses on letting go of the past. I shaved my hair. I had my Britney Spears moment. My hair's all grown back now. It's just reflecting on self, and there's a lot of fire in the music video. From the ashes we rise.
Always willing to learn, this triple SAMA-winning songwriter felt like adding a recipe to her repertoire.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine.
Can I give you a little COVID?
Yes.
Shekhinah.
Nice to meet you, Shekhinah. I am Chef Laura. I'm the resident chef at Lotus Magnus.
Thank you for having me in your kitchen. Chef Laura, what are we eating today? What are we making?
So we're going to do a black rice and prawn salad with lovely crudités and vegetables.
Yum.
A warm, warm-hearted creme anglaise,
ooh,
which is spiced by lime leaves and cardamom.
Yeah. Yum.
So you can actually use just about any crunchy seasonal vegetables. I have got here red cabbage and spring onions, red pepper, might add a bit of yellow pepper as well, and some carrot, cucumber. And the actual dressing, which is the secret ingredient here, is a base of garlic, chili, ginger, a bit of massaman curry paste,
okay,
some turmeric, some coconut cream.
Yum. I'm ready to eat. Like, I'm always ready to eat. Like, how can I help?
Okay, so what you can start for me so long is you can start to harvest the strawberries.
Okay.
Just take out the leaves.
What are you doing on that side?
And here I am busy prepping our veg.
What else are we doing? What do we have left to do?
How fast is the sauce?
We are actually, the sauce is now done. It's reduced slightly.
Smells great.
I'm just going to finish it off with a little pinch of brown sugar, just to balance the saltiness of it. And then we are gonna take a nice big bowl and we're gonna combine our vegetables.
Okay.
And add the dressing in the end with the rice.
It's the kind of attention to detail which the creator of Ludus Magnus Villas puts into every feature. Regis Maniora's investment is a tribute to these surrounds.
I've been traveling a lot, and I basically this project is it's a combination of a lot of traveling, a lot of experience. Look, Franschhoek is beautiful, and it's the gold triangle between Paarl, Stellenbosch and Franschhoek. The global project was not to have a normal guest house, but what was to offer different experience for the guest between lifestyle, between sports, between just relaxing in a beautiful and peaceful atmosphere. We've got four villas, having a total of 17 en suite, 7 pools, a 25 meter pool for the main villa. All the rooms, they are completely different, using different wallpapers, different tile, different fabric. So every en suite, every building have its own character. The base of our project was to be completely off the grid and to be sustainable. And we generate our own power with the beautiful sunshine of Africa. We also have, I'm a big in love with animals, and we have a farm animal rescue. It's animals that we did rescue.
For hard-working songwriters in need of refuge, there is the renowned spa.
I just had the most amazing back and neck massage. I feel absolutely zenned out. I didn't realize how much tension I was carrying in my back, but now I'm feeling good. What a wonderful way to kind of end off this beautiful day in this beautiful space. I've had the most amazing day. Thank you so much for joining me on this little journey. I feel relaxed, I feel blessed, hashtag spoiled girls worldwide. I look forward to seeing everyone again back at the festivals. It's been 2 years off and away from you. I hope this little bit of content brought us closer together again. You know where to find me at Shekhinah D on all social media platforms. Cheers to us, cheers to 2021, and yeah, I will see you all soon.
Coming up, a new business opportunity opens up beneath the sea, and teach a man to fish, or see what happens when a woman learns to farm. Enterprise Adéle Grosse has built up on the West Coast echoes her philosophy to think, ink, share, and action. She does her best thinking exploring the sea, inks that in images caught on camera, shares them through her decor brand, and actions a wider love of the ocean.
Studio Sea Love is a design and decor company that brings the ocean alive in people's homes, in people's lives. It started when I started to snorkel, probably around about 2016, when my son was diagnosed with leukemia and I had to get him in the water. So that was me starting to snorkel because that was the safest place to get him to do some exercise. We decided that was too dangerous for my son, who was then on daily chemo, to live in Cape Town. And with the lockdown, we decided to move up to the West Coast.
Away from greater COVID risk, Adéle's son continued with chemo and recovery while the sea played its part.
We ended up in this amazing, beautiful Shekhinah Bay, and I just found myself so drawn to the sea. And I just really loved to capture what I saw while I was snorkeling. So I started to take a lot of photos and I started to take videos, and I was sharing it on my platforms, and people started to say, show it to more people.
Following the cue of friend and Oscar-winning filmmaker Craig Foster, who made the docu My Octopus Teacher, Adéle has immersed herself in this world.
So I'm right and ready to head into the ocean, which is my absolute nature's nurturing moment. I've got my fabulous camera and I'm heading to get some nature's nurturing. So the West Coast, I think a lot of people think it's just too rough, but there's such diversity, and I've got this urge to show people the flowers in the ocean, to give people a view of the most beautiful ocean bloom. And it just gives you such an incredible peace, and yeah, it nurtures your soul like you can't believe it.
In this case, the catch of the day remains as fresh as the second it's captured.
Okay, cool, what a great snorkel, and now it's time to see what I've got on my camera. So now I go and load it onto my computer, and I'm now downloading my images and I'm downloading my video clips, because part and parcel of the uniqueness is that all my images connect you via a QR code to the live video footage that I then allow the user of the product to dive into with me. It's limited edition. Each and every image has got a name and a story. I tell you exactly where it was taken, when it was taken, and I very much give each and every image a name. I do not use any design program. I don't have that. So what I saw underneath when I was snorkeling is what you see on your product.
At just the time every business, including printing and decor, was struggling, in walked a breath of fresh air.
I'm here at my amazing printers. They do all the printing of all my different products, and I specifically chose them because, number one, they're local, and number two, they use natural fabrics and they use fabrics that's recyclable. So that was incredibly important for me. So that is something that I linked very well with, because that's their ethos as well, is really going into the natural and going into environmentally friendly.
As long as you have a desktop publishing operator as skilled as Lee O'Connor making it a reality.
Okay, so this process over here is a pigment printing process. What we do is we first send the fabric off to get pre-treated. Then when it gets back, we can then print onto it. We then put it through a heat curing process at 165 degrees. As it goes through, what happens is the pores of the fabrics opens up and then the ink sets in, so the product's basically fully washable, fully wearable, and ready to be produced into a product.
What's nice about these recycled products made of plastic bottles is that they are incredibly functional, because you basically, after using them, just put them in the washing machine. And they come out perfectly colored, still perfectly in shape. And the best of all is you're not doing something harmful to our most beautiful earth and ocean. So where to from here? fashion line. I'm working on a beautiful fashion line, clothing for men, women, and children, utilizing all my amazing underwater images.
Adéle jokes about her life. Never Adéle moment. What a businesswoman, mother, and inspiration to those around her. To make sense of the vast World Food Day initiative this spring, we visited the Living Soils Community Learning Farm in partnership with Woolworths and their CSI program manager, Katie Hayes.
Woolworths has always been really passionate about making a difference in the community. It's part of our purpose, the difference that inspires and cares. And we've been actively involved in food security projects and in particular with different organizations. The inspiration behind this project came when we sat together with SPEAR and the Sustainability Institute and wanted to make a bigger difference around food security. And together we co-created the Living Soils Community Learning Farm.
Living Soils is a mixed vegetable production farm that is about 3 hectares and based in the Lyndog Valley in Stellenbosch. The partners at Woolworths, which is our primary funding partner, Speer Wine Farm is the resource partner, so they've offered us the land and some of the primary resources that we use for the operations of the farm, and SI, which is the research, knowledge and project management partner. The project employs 14 people, of which 12 are women. And the reason for this is that we realize that agriculture is a big sector in the country and primarily has women as laborers, but they're never really given opportunities to be more than that. And then so on Living Soils, we provide a platform of not only working and employment, but then also of capacitating and building the women into more than laborers and being capable farmers.
This project aligns very much to our good business journey. We have a number of commitments that aim to reduce our business environmental impacts on the one hand, and on the other hand, to improve and increase our social and economic impact that we are making. And this particular project fits in very much with our good business journey along the lines of social development. We believe in food security and making a difference where we can, but we also understand that food security is quite multidimensional and requires a number of different approaches to how you address it. So how we look at food security is we look at it through different levels. The level one being where people need food to eat right now, and there we support them through surplus food donations and through a partnership that we have with Food Forward SA. The next level that we see is where people are encouraged to grow their own food. So you're empowering and enabling people to grow their own food so that they don't have to rely on donations to able to access food. The third level is when you move from subsistence farming into more enterprise development and you see people growing food that they're able to sell and make an income from. And then the last area that we think we can make a difference in is ensuring how we grow the food. We need to have food that is sustainable, and we do that by using regenerative and sustainable farming practices. Now, this particular project, Living Soils, reaches into all of those different levels of food need, so it's really important to us. We have contributed financially to the project. We've donated around $4 million to the 3-year pilot, but above that, we've had our food technologists, our food security manager, and also our dietitian getting involved with knowledge transfer. So they've done things like integrated pest management, they've done things like the science behind regenerative farming, and then also how you apply that practically, and then also looked at basic nutrition as well. So we've got involved in a number of ways.
We provide experiential internships that provide not only practical learning, but then also complemented with leadership, entrepreneurship, and holistic development of the individual. And this will enable them to stand on their own when they go and start their own farming enterprises.
While on her way to that goal is Living Soils farmer Sindiswa Mdodana.
This have changed my life because, as we all know, that in South Africa we're facing a huge number of youth that are unemployed. So it was very fortunate for me to be one of the people who get a chance to be part of Living Soils, which helped me to be self-sustained, that I can do things on my own and growing food that I know it's healthy. So that have helped me a lot. It's about taking care of nature, and it's about being aware of the health issues that we have. And if ever we can know that healthy soil give a healthy life, then I think that can help us, especially as young people, because we are the future generations. So with us knowing the basics and the elements of doing things right, I think we can go far. So that's what I'm heading to, make people see that this is the future.
we also address and support local food security through providing food to feeding schemes in ECDs, and we currently support around 200 children within the local valley. Since the lockdown, we've also been supporting food relief efforts by also going to households directly, and then we've provided weekly vegetable boxes since then.
World Food Day was on the 16th of October. It's very much an important day. It aligns with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals of Zero Hunger, which this project subscribes to. And the theme for the year was Our Actions Are Our Future, Better Production, Better Nutrition, Better Environment, and a Better Future. And this particular project is aligning to all of those things. We are growing food, we are training people, we're changing people's livelihoods, and we're doing so in an environmentally friendly way.
Grow a young woman's capacity to farm successfully and watch her community transform. Next up, what would your furniture like to wear? Who says a rug belongs on the floor? Why should the fashion capitals include Vosloorus? What are you saying when you say it with sneakers? How about asking your clients what they want? And you stand a chance of winning a smartphone worth 20,000 Rand when you answer the weekly show-related question on our social media platforms. Whatever business you're in, you need to capture the attention of your potential market. In the decor world, even the finest designed and made fabrics face a world of competition. So, local manufacturer Lorna Bailey returned to her roots to gain an edge.
My passion for fabric started in the clothing industry, which is what I studied formally, clothing and textile design. And it just became very clear to me the crossover and correlation of clothing design and interior design. Basically, the way we wear a scarf and a shirt and a jacket and how we coordinate ourselves is exactly what we do in interiors. And we put patterns together, we put planes together, we dress the furniture. We design locally in South Africa and weave locally. The global appeal of our range is following international trends, as well as creating our own, which are African inspired. And Africa itself is hot property.
To excite her clients' imagination, Lorna put her fashion design hat on and got social.
Fashion for Furnishings campaign started with the idea that we were dressing the furniture in fashion. And we somehow had to take that to the media being decor magazines, Instagram, Facebook, all of those platforms that we use to put out there.
The design of the dress in this campaign is inspired by 20s design, Audrey Hepburn look. It is complemented with a satin ribbon at the end to match the black frame of the furniture.
The brief was a welcome change for Johan Boeter, a designer renowned for bridal wear.
For us, it's like playing around, because every time you've got a bride, or it's always the same. Every time when we do something for them, it's totally different. And every time it's a challenge, because we want to take it that little step further, because making upholstery material or curtain material into a dress, it's always a big challenge. But we love challenges. Lorna sent us a picture of what she wants the ad to look like. And then we have to go and think of the dress and how we're going to make that. Now, doing a dress like this, where there's like a lot of bulk at the bottom and then still keep your pattern straight, is very, very difficult. So we actually decided that we were going to do like a segment dress that we can keep the lines inside and like build a cage underneath it to keep all the lines and everything in shape.
Lorna's concept is shaking up the furniture trade, and bespoke manufacturers are loving it.
It's been a nice marketing campaign for showcasing that interiors can be fashionable.
The fabrics that were presented to us were particular colors and designs, and we had to choose specific styles and designs of furniture so they could complement each other and make it a successful range.
A drop of creative marketing is sure to make waves across the local industry and abroad.
You work with creative eye candy to capture. The setting is always beautiful and the storytelling is easy.
The end results of our photo shoots are always amazing because everyone that takes part are true professionals and they just always do the end result such justice for that final shot, which I'm sure will be as amazing as always. The Mill Fabrics has been very successful in our own in-house designs, and that of course gives us exclusivity, and that's definitely a focus for the future, which sets us apart from other commodity products, and also to focus on local content as well as recycled content, which is becoming more and more important and necessary, and also export into Africa and globally, which we currently do for other clients, but with our own range exclusively to designated countries.
No one gets 15 minutes of fame today. Your product gets barely a second to stand out in the social media landscape. And by seizing these moments, Lorna's brand looks set to endure. As South Africans, we are creative in our very nature. Those who innovate our latest trends in business, music, health, fashion, film, and more have now inspired Vodacom to reimagine their red product portfolio. Chief Officer for Consumer Business, George Mendez, is proud of their new value-driven experiences.
Hey guys, George Mendez here. So good to see you. Welcome to my world, the Vodacom world. So let's go inside and check it out. Yeah, so effectively, when we talk about experiencing red, it's obviously the Vodacom red, and more specifically, the Vodacom red packages. You get so many more benefits, so much more value by just taking out one of the red plans. It's more than just the standard voice and data package. So maybe we can have a look at what these amazing offers have. The red VIP packages unlock amazing benefits and rewards, travel, entertainment, premium services, signature experiences, includes red roaming, so when you're traveling overseas, data sharing for the family, multi-SIM environment, so you can have multiple SIM cards eating from the same bundle, device insurance, and the list goes on, you know. So we've got rewards, real red VIP benefits, lifestyle rewards. Lifestyle rewards are amazing discounts at hotels, certain restaurants, concierge service, Sweat 1000, Amazon Prime Video, and the list goes on. Beautiful packages that customers have asked us for, and therefore we've customized them.
For Tapela Mokwenya and Jay Something, it's sharing their gigs of data with friends and family. Multi-SIM connectivity does it for Khartya Hankitsia. Travel rewards for Maps Maponyane, and uploading new content anytime is the big win for Dr. Kanile.
So the approach that we've taken is, instead of doing the same thing all the time and us designing products and services that we think customers want, we did something very innovative and very basic, which is just asking the customers what they want. We needed to get a little creative and make sure that we catered for their lifestyle needs. So for some, it was insurance propositions that they wanted bundled in. For others, it was maybe some entertainment that was bundled in. And so what we did is took all this feedback and we propositioned these tariff plans in total lifestyle packages.
When your lifestyle is central to your work, or the demands of a creative profession mean you often connect with family on the go, the benefits can make it work.
And so one of the most innovative things that we've launched that's never been done before is VodaPay, our super app. It's a one-stop mall in your pocket. It's got payment capabilities, buying airtime, all sorts of different products. We have more than 50 business partners on board already. If you like it, you can VodaPay it, because it's going to be available everywhere. And this will become the new norm of how to pay for things. Every retailer you could go to and pay with a QR code. And you have all of this in one device. And it's not just for Vodacom customers. Any customer on any network can get this. It's free to use. There's no data being consumed on this application. You want to talk creativity? This is it. This is creativity at its best. You know, catering for a whole diverse range of customers, we had to make sure that we have something for everyone. So we have the red flexi category, which is effectively our sort of silver category. And that allows customers to be able to choose how they want to spend their voice and data, and they get some extra benefits. Then we go into the red core category. That's effectively our gold category. That gives you a few more additional benefits. For example, some smoothies at Kauai and things like that, in addition to traditional voice and data, SMS. And then we have our red VIP category, and that's split into sort of platinum and diamond. And those are the top end. And effectively, that gives you all the benefits. So we have, in addition to traditional voice and data, the massive discounts on flights, accommodation, and so the list goes on.
Experience Red and unlock more with Vodacom Red. Stand a chance to win one of 10 10 gig data bundles courtesy of Vodacom. To enter, find the Vodacom post on the Insider SA social pages and comment on the post telling us what you like most about their new plans. Comp closes at midnight on Saturday, 6 November. Winners will be announced on Expresso on Monday morning, 8 November. T's and C's apply and can be found on the insidersa.co.za. Right after this, rug artist James White creates a market all on his own. And for a young David Tlale in search of inspiration, the streets of his hometown were paved with gold.
Insider SA, connected by Vodacom Red. Switch to a new Vodacom Red plan to unlock more.
Anyone who told James White that graffiti-inspired rugs wouldn't cut it is no student of hip-hop culture. He's taken the art of the streets and, with a DIY attitude, he's grabbed hold of accessible technology and just done it.
Hey guys, come on inside. I'm James, aka Henry Hamilton, and welcome to the home of Hamilton Rugs. My artistic journey started when I was about 10 or 11. Noticing graffiti on the highways, it was a big influence, and also 90s skateboarding culture influenced me a lot. The designs really popped out at me. The bold colors and bold lines I really enjoyed. So I would say around when I was about 14 years old, I started painting graffiti, and that really helped me with composition of artwork and knowing what colors would go with each other. I really thrived at art and design in high school, and then after high school, I studied advertising.
Creating pop culture rugs wasn't on the career guidance list at high school or at college, so he put it there.
I started to notice on Instagram people were making rugs with a machine called a tufting gun, and I just thought, wow, I need to get one of those. A few weeks later, my tufting gun arrived and my rug journey began. This was one of the first pieces I made using a punch needle. The punch needle gives a loop effect, whereas the tufting gun gives a cut effect. Let me show you how the punch needle works. It's just a one continuous loop with the yarn, and you go through the fabric. I find working with the punch needle quite therapeutic. The only downside of it takes way more time than the tufting gun. This is my tufting gun. It's a cut power tufting gun. What that means is each time it goes through the fabric, scissors come out and cut the yarn. So I've got my material here, and I stick it through. So you'll see this process is way faster than the punch needle.
If the immediate touch of a spray can nozzle under his finger is lost by designing like this, James recoups that in-person feel for his art by working in yarn.
Each rug begins with me stretching the material onto the frame. Once I'm happy with the tightness of the material, I'll project my design onto the frame. I've always loved using bright colors, so I think that's also why I love using yarn, because the color selection is amazing. I love the texture that the wool gives on the hand. I feel like it gives the artwork a more functional feel in the house. It can be used as a rug or a wall hanging. When I project the image onto my fabric, I need to flip the image. So once I'm done with the design, I'll cut away all these loose strands and I'll glue the back, holding all the yarn in place. Here are some of my completed designs. It's a mixture between commission pieces and some of my own artwork. I've taken inspiration from spray cans, sneaker culture, and of course aliens. With my artwork, I like to create dream worlds. I feel like it takes the viewer away from the daily hustle and bustle of life.
Making a place for that vision, a forward-looking gallery in Woodstock, Cape Town, has now offered James walls, not floors, for his rugs.
The owner of the gallery contacted me through Instagram and asked me if I wanted to exhibit my pieces here. The cool thing about this gallery is that artists don't have to adhere to the strict rules that other galleries have in place. The inspiration for this piece came from the brand of spray cans that I use. And the nozzles on the side are extra caps that we use for painting graffiti with. That's a banana cap and that's a New York fat cap. I would like to work with some big brands in the future and hopefully work up to a solo show where I can transform a whole gallery into my own imaginary world.
Many young talents who make it with their own street-inspired businesses share James's roots in graffiti culture. They're all looking to make their own individual stamp on the world of brands and creative marketing. Before the success of David Tlale's brand, his grounding was township street, church, school, and stepping out on the town fashion. It gave him the key, not just to how people want to dress, but more importantly, why.
Hello everyone, my name is David Tlale. I'm a fashion designer based in Johannesburg, South Africa. Today, I welcome you to my home in Vosloorus. My growing up in Vosloorus was really creative. I was raised in a family of four, and all of us were raised by a single mom. I was the one who was doing most of the chores. Taught me quite a lot. Taught me to be neat, taught me to be clean, and to make sure that wherever I stay or wherever I live, it's a presentable place. I started playing dress up with my mother because I could put in anything that I wanted. Along the journey, she became my number one fan, and when I started winning best student in my second year and third year, she was very proud. It don't matter where you live, in township or in a squatter camp or anything else, but when you step out, you always look the best. Customers feel very comfortable to know that you are David Tlale and they're meeting David Tlale. I mean, you can think about all the global brands that people trade with. You never get to meet the other big brands or even the person that even started it. It feels comfortable and it feels natural. It's not a forced journey to trade as David Tlale.
After school, he studied fashion and technology at Vaal University, where he then lectured. It's important to him to show his hometown the payoff from that journey.
The importance of hosting a high-end showcase in Vosloorus at this civic center was to bring it to life what we do on the local and international stage, and also to give our community, you know, where we are born, a glimpse of what is actually the real world of fashion.
We are a brand that is very much conscious of where we come from, where South Africa is going. What are the ergonomics around that? Ergonomics simply means how can you involve community in whatever it is that you're trying to do and actually inspire them.
Why I brought it home, it's something that I've always wanted to do, and I think the economy of our townships or of our spaces need to be revitalized by us, and we need to, you know, ignite that dream and that vision for the child that does not know that the creative space can be lucrative, can be a business, can also be means of living on a daily basis.
The new collection reflects the beauty and diversity of our continent.
It's quite a fun collection. First of all, we look at the times that we're living in and how people are dressing up today. They want much more relaxed clothing, colorful, but yet still fashionable. So the whole concept is just layering in luxury fabrics and prints that you see. The collection, we're celebrating some of the icons that we've had. People feel good when they're wearing a brand that they actually know, they can resonate with. And we've developed this beautiful Tlale print. And the beauty about our prints, they are all developed in-house. We print them in-house and then we make the garments in-house. And obviously a bit of a bedazzled moment. And you know, the beauty about this collection is that it's a mix and match. You can wear it with any item in your wardrobe and you can just dress it up or dress it down. I mean, this top with these pants just on its own looks absolutely chic. Elements of tailoring, which we pride ourselves as a brand, David Tlale. This is a beautifully tailored woman's jacket with our signature tails that we've had for the past three seasons.
We joined the maestro for the Winelands launch of his spring-summer showing in silk, lace, and luxury fabric sequins.
What I really loved most about this collection is how the puzzle actually came together, because it all started out as a concept, you know, with the villa, the Boschendal villa, and how we're going to actually present our spring-summer collection. I mean, the models, the hair, the makeup, and we look at the print that we actually developed that actually exudes a lot of artistic elements, and also the journey of picking different models and bringing them together under this beautiful, I'd say, landscape.
So my overall thoughts of David's new collection was that it's inspiring, it's creative, it's fun. I can see us wearing it every day, which is so amazing.
I mean, I expect nothing less from him. You know, he always takes things to the next level. This theme was immigration. And I was wondering, like, what is he gonna do, you know? And just how he brought, like, parts of our history and, like, how we're moving forward to it. I mean, I think it was absolutely amazing.
Print of design is very beautiful. It's the summertime and the yellows bring the brightness. And yeah, and the fit, I love it. It's sexy, elegant, and this is David. You never know what to expect from him. It's always, every collection comes with something beautiful for every woman. You know, every woman feel elegant, and one of them is me, so I'm so happy to do the show with him.
David as a creative is an incredible designer who will eventually, in a couple of years, ensure, like, he has a lot of stores around the world, which is, for a South African designer, it's going to be quite big. So it's always great working with David. I work behind the scenes and in front of the scenes, so I'll always get to see both contrasts of David, yeah.
I think it just, like, it just shows when you have a vision, everything just comes together. And beyond anything else is how I have so much love and support from my customers, from also the partners that we work with. It's just, like, literally mind-blowing.
With family, business, social, and creative life as unpredictable as it is right now, David hopes his collection will encourage people to have a positive outlook, be inspired, and know that this too shall pass. Coming up, when you've got 17 million customers and planning on more, it pays to get creative when letting them know each one is your favorite.
Sponsored by Capitec. Simplify banking. Live better.
To drive home the message that Capitec really is a bank for all South Africans, their new creative campaign showcases the bank's inclusivity and range of offerings catering to all clients, no matter who you are.
When Capitec was founded 20 years ago, we asked a couple of simple questions about banking. We asked, why can you not bank on Sundays or after 3:30 in the afternoon? Why is it so expensive? Why do you have to fill in countless forms just to put your money in and then again to get it out? And it's that challenging mindset that pioneered banking in South Africa that allowed Capitec to grow to the brand that it is today. And we continue that journey with this campaign. What we did now is we questioned, why are people in banking defined by their status as a student or as a pensioner or as a high net worth individual? Why are people categorized by the color of their bank card? In fact, South Africa is a country rich in diversity, and we want to celebrate that diversity. We have 17 million people who call Capitec their bank, and all of them are unique. But they all have one thing in common. It's simple, transparent banking that is designed to be in their best interest. We've moved from a business that is branch-based, where people can go into a branch to open an account, to the leading digital bank in South Africa. Live Better for us is a philosophy, and it's a philosophy that our clients buy into, but it's also a philosophy that our 17,000 employees buy into. And everyone at Capitec, on a daily basis, ask questions to challenge the status quo and do things differently, ultimately to create a better solution for our clients.
The campaign is launching in a uniquely Capitec way, disrupting the space and making an impact.
For the launch of our brand new TVC, we wanted to do something a little bit different. The COVID-19 pandemic does limit how you can do a party, so we will be doing a watch party, but it will be virtual. Our TVC is all about celebrating the differences within our client base. Whether you love a sneaker or a stiletto, we are still the bank for you. To create a little bit more excitement around the virtual party, we have now extended our partnership with ASICS and KO with the Live Better sneaker to make the Live Better sneaker for our influencer and media friends. For the watch party, 36 influencer and media friends will be joining us to watch a screening of the TVC. We hope they enjoy it, as well as the food that we'll be sending through on the day, and hope that they have their Live Better sneaker on while they're watching.
What would TikTok star Nangamso Puwani, aka The Real Soso, think?
Omska, are you mine? You're mine. Love, man. Live Better.
Since launching on TikTok last year, Nangamso has earned almost 400,000 followers.
What I like about creating TikTok videos is that you do not have to pretend to be someone else. You can be yourself, you can wear whatever you want to wear. You don't have to wear makeup to fit in a specific category. So I think that's what I love about creating content. The impact of my videos have been very inspirational, especially to women with dark skin and natural hair, because it has allowed them to be more comfortable and more confident in who they are and embracing what they have. My biggest achievement within the TikTok space has been being selected to be part of the Rising Voices program. They wanted 100 TikTok creators, and I was part of that. It helped me to enhance and amplify my skills of creating content. I'm very excited about the virtual watch party. I'll definitely be there with my Live Better sneakers. Can't get over them, so yeah, I'm very happy about that. I am a Capitec supporter because Capitec is affordable, Capitec is convenient, and they really help clients to live better.
At Capitec, we don't care how much you earn, or if you've been with us for 8 years or 8 minutes.
What appealed to me about the TVC is that no matter who you are or no matter what you're into, be it sneakers or stilettos, you can still bank simply and live better with Capitec.
More than 17 million people do it with us every day.
Yay! That was awesome. Okay, I'm all partied out. Now it's just me and my Live Better sneakers.
You stand a chance of winning your own pair of custom-designed Capitec kicks. We are giving away 2 pairs of Live Better Japan Air sneakers. To enter, simply reply to the competition post with your shoe size on the Insider SA social media platforms using hashtag LiveBetter. T's and C's apply and can be found on the Insider SA website. Get more of the Insider SA online. follow, connect, engage, and be inspired to live better with the Insider Essay. Watch the show Monday evenings at 5:30. Repeat Saturday at 1 on S3.